Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul.
Pastor Dr. Lawson Ngua is the General Overseer of Sunrise Banner Bible Church worldwide, with international headquarters in Abuja, Nigeria. Pastor Dr. Lawson Ngua is commissioned by God to provide the ministry of the Word of God and to disciple the whole world through the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Sunrise Banner Bible Church, we believe in God. We believe what God says.
Father, we do believe that tonight, everything you have in stock, you will unveil them to us in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for answering our prayers. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. So they have been looking at the study, Roadmap to a New Nation. Roadmap to a New Nation. I've come to discover that there is a new nation, and there is a new Nigeria. And I believe that God will give us a new nation. And God will give us a new Nigeria in Jesus' name. But we need to see the roadmap. What are the roadmap for us to achieve a new Nigeria? And you can't separate your nations from your growth. If the nations is growing, then your growth will expand. You can't separate the family from the life. And so we're looking at Proverbs 14, and that is going to be our text tonight. Proverbs chapter 14 in verse 34. Proverbs 14 verse 34. Are we there? Good. So it reads, righteousness exalted in nations, but sin is a reproach to any people. So here you see the roadmap to a new nations. That if there is any nations that we do well, that nations must be built on righteousness. In Proverbs 11, verse 11. Proverbs 11, verse 11. In verse 11, it says, by the blessing of the upright, the city is what? Exalted. So a city cannot be exalted if there is no blessing of an upright man. If there are no upright people in a city, that city can never. Same thing is applicable to a church. Same thing is applicable to a family. Same thing is applicable to an individual. If there is any man that wants to grow, that man can only grow on the basis of righteousness. Now, why must Nigeria and the churches in Nigeria and the people of Nigeria, why do we need righteousness? Because of these 10 reasons. Number one, Nigeria need rest. Because we need rest. As you go around today, you see restlessness everywhere. People are restless because we need rest. Number two, because we need relief. We need release. We want to be released from poverty. We want to be released from so-called insecurity. We want to be released from, you know, joblessness. We want to be released from a situation that looks like there is no roadmap, there is no definition to where we are going to. And so, our prayer is to have a nation that have a roadmap, that have a compass, that you can say, we are here today, and tomorrow we are going to be here. And I'm praying that in these nations and in this church, our roadmap will be very clear. Amen. Give me a loudest amen. Amen. Why do we need this kind of nation? Number three, we need renewal. We need new brain. Nigeria needs renewal. We need new brain. This is 59 years old. And I'm seeing a man with 59 years old that he doesn't seem to renew his idea. He doesn't seem to renew his strategy. It's as though the people who were born before Nigeria were born remain constantly in power. And you barely see a new brain, new idea. So Nigeria needs renewal. And as a people and as a church, we also need renewal. Pray that God will give us new ideas. I'm not hearing your good amen. God will give us new ideas in these nations. Number four, Nigeria needs reconciliations. Nigeria needs reconciliations. We have fight enough. You know, every time opposition fight, deal with him, kill him, quack him. We need dialogue. We need reconciliations. This nation needs reconciliations. Number five, Nigeria needs restorations. I pray tonight that as we mark 59, there will be total restoration in this nation. My brother, if you love this nation, this night we will pray for this nation. Because we don't have second Nigeria. This is the only property we have. There cannot be Sunrise Banner Bible Church without Nigeria. If Nigeria is in trouble today, Sunrise will not have service. Are you hearing what I'm saying? One of these days, I heard a news in Numa that they were shooting in Numa. And I couldn't sleep that morning because I just saw it on the bar, on the news. And I picked up my phone. Called the pastor that is in Numa. I said, please, I'm seeing a news right now that there is a problem in Numa. Where are you? That is the implication. So, if Nigeria is in peace, the church will be in peace. Am I talking to you? If Nigeria is progressing, the church will progress. If the economy of Nigeria is improving, the church will equally do what? Improves. Nobody can deny his mother. Even when you say it's not your mother, the blood of your mother will speak. Can I hear you say amen? So Nigeria bet us. And you can't disappear nowhere. So number five, Nigeria need what? Restoration. And we pray that God will give restoration to this nation. Number six, Nigeria needs redemption. Nigeria needs redemption. We need to be redeemed. This country needs to be redeemed from the hands of what you call cabals. And I know God will redeem this nation. You know, sometimes I sat down to look at our nation, Nigeria, and I see it in the hands of just 11 persons. Just 11 persons. God will bring this nation from few hands and give it to everybody. Amen. Give me a loudest amen. Amen. Number 7, Nigeria needs reformation. Needs reformation. And let me tell you, when we talked about Nigeria, quote and unquote, you can't be holding Nigeria. Nigeria is not like this speaker that you can touch. Nigeria is you. Who is Nigeria? Can I hear you? Who is Nigeria? You are Nigeria. So when we are talking about Nigeria, we are talking about you. If you are reformed, Nigeria will be reformed. That's the truth. If you stop paying bribe today, bribe will stop. Oh yes. If you stop sin today, sin will stop in Nigeria. It's very simple. The corruption, whatsoever you call corruption, if every individual of Nigeria says we are stopping corruption, corruption will stop. So therefore, when they say Nigerians are this, Nigerians are this, I'm looking for that Nigeria, and I can see that Nigeria standing preaching. Can you give me a loudest amen? Amen? You know, I'm proud of this country, I'm telling you. Some time back, I traveled around some countries and I discovered that all my movement, all I was eating was grass. Say grass. Like animal. This is the only country where you eat anything you want. If you want to eat yam, there is another one they call three leaf yam, coco yam, whatever yam again, pepper yam. You have water yam. You have, just name them. You want to eat swallow, there is this one they call akpu. There is one they call oh my God. If you want to eat soup, you have all kind of soup. Cross out of Nigeria. You will eat grass and know your life. God will keep this country. Amen. Give me a loudest amen. Amen. You know, so many of you have not traveled out. That's, you don't understand. You don't understand. Travel out of Nigeria, you will understand. You don't understand. This is the only country you can sleep. And when you are sleeping, you can sleep very well. You are not afraid whether the ground where you are sleeping will collapse. No earthquake. The only earthquake we have in Nigeria is hunger. God bless you. No earthquake. And any man that is hungry in Nigeria is not caused by Nigeria. It's caused by him or her. Nigeria is the only country you can carry corn, seed of corn, throw for ground. You no put sand, it go grow. No country like Nigeria. I'm telling you, you won't know. You won't understand what I'm telling you. No country like this country. This country is so blessed. So blessed. And I know we will be blessed in this country. Number 7. Number 8. Thank you very much. We're preaching this message together today. Number 8. Nigeria needs restitution. Nigeria has killed so many innocent people. People who have not held, people who have not done anything wrong. Nigeria needs to restitute. Yeah. Nigeria needs restitution. Number 9. Nigeria needs renunciations. We need to renounce all our errors. We need to say bye-bye to sin and to some acts. Nigeria needs renunciations. And then number 10, Nigeria needs reflections. Nigeria needs to start reflecting on where he's going. What has stopped him from getting to where he's going to? And like I said, that every members of Nigeria, every individual in Nigeria, and in Nigeria himself, you need reflection. There are times you see people, they are already 20 years old, 40 years old, 45 years old, even 59 years like Nigeria, and yet he doesn't know where he's going to. There are people like that. There is no plan. If you ask him, where are you going to, where are you coming from, he doesn't know where he's going to, he doesn't know where he's coming from. What is your next plan? You are now 59. What are you doing? It tells you, don't worry, I'm believing God. In fact, at 59, he doesn't have a word of God. His life is as empty as you don't know how to describe it. So, you need to reflect. You need to reflect. You need to check. How far have you gone? Where are you now? Where do you ought to be? If you reflect on your journey, you will think about your journey and you will correct yourself. It's only a stupid man that have refused to correct himself. And let me tell you the truth. No man can correct you. Only you can correct yourself. And any correction you cannot give to yourself, no pastor can give it to you. You're the only one. So you're the only one that is owing yourself. And I pray you will make corrections in Jesus' name. In Isaiah 43, 18 and 19. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. God will do a new thing in Nigeria. And that is why it is roadmap to a new Nigeria. Roadmap to a new nation. And then it says in verse 19, now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in where? And river in where again? In desert. And let believers give me a great, great amen there. Amen. Great and manifold are our expectation for our beloved nations, Nigeria. We love this nation dearly. And so great is our own expectation for these nations. So therefore, we desire the peace. We desire peace for this nation too. We desire progress for these nations. 3, we desire prosperity for these nations. And then 4, we aspire to be one of the top 20 economy in the world. And I know that is very possible. We can be the top 20 economy of the world. I believe that can be very possible. And God can do that in Nigeria in Jesus' name. Amen. But how do we get there? How do we get there? That is the question. So many times people know about a dream. People have dreams. Having a dream is one thing. Having a nation is another thing. Having the road map to get to your dream is the major thing. You can go to school. You have all the papers, all the graduate, blah, blah, blah. Get everything. It's not enough. There is nobody you will call today to ask whether or not you have a dream that will not tell you that he has one dream or the other. What is difficult is not the dream. The difficulty is the roadmap to see the end of the dream. The challenge of Nigeria is not because Nigeria doesn't have a budget. This country has the best budget, name it anywhere. Constitution is there. Take our laws. You have all the laws you want to mention. But implementation of our laws is a problem. The roadmap to get to where we want to go, that is the case. And the same thing is applied and applicable to you. You say you'll be called as a pastor. That's good. Perfect. But you do have a roadmap. How did you want to get there? Did you have it? That is one of the things I love about this commission. We know we have a roadmap and we have a direction. So we know where we're going to. In your own personal dream, in your family, do you have a roadmap? Do you know that there are people who have a family and they don't have what they call family drawing board? They don't have. That's to say, you wake up in the morning, there is what they call family drawing board. On that board, it is an inner board that it happens in your diaries. You have three children. All right, so I have this. Okay, now it's 3 years. So in 6 years, it will finish this. In 9 years, it would have been done with this. What do I need to do when it's still 3 years so that by the time I get to 9 years, I'm already ready for him or her? Okay, so do I need to put this and this together so that by the time it gets to 15 years, I'm already there for him or her? You know, they don't have a roadmap for their children. Their name is Mr. Emergency. School just resumed now. You're running up and down looking for school fees. Where were you 3 months back? Where were you? No roadmap. You're looking for who will borrow you now. In fact, very soon, some of you will come to me and say, Daddy, my pikin never go back to school. You are foolish. You don't think. This is what you ought to have think 5 months, 6 months, 7 months ago. That is why you see people from church today running up and down, house rent. One called me today, he said they carry his load and throw outside. Why would they not throw your load outside? You don't plan. No roadmap. There is no direction. There is nothing like, I have 10,000 today, so I need to save 2,000. And between social time to social time, I want to do this, and I want to do this, and I want to do this. Some will tell you, I don't even have a kiss, so why do I need to plan? You must plan because you will have a kiss. Oh, yes. Bible says, no barren in thy land. You must plan for tomorrow. That's just the problem for Nigeria. Can you look up here? By January this year, virtually all of you plan. there was something you write down. Am I correct? One thing is a plan. Another thing is the continuation of your plan. If you plan and you're not focused on that plan, it will not work. And be consistent on that plan, it will not work. So I'm going to show you some roadmap tonight on how the roadmap for this country and the roadmap for your life. And if you follow this roadmap, trust me, you will succeed. Amen. I'm not hearing your amen. Amen. How many of you want to succeed? God will help you tonight. You will succeed in Jesus' name. How do we get there? We can only get there by following the roadmap. Now, what is the first alphabet on the roadmap, everybody? I'll stand for recalling our foundations. The first roadmap is to record your foundation. The first roadmap for Nigeria is for Nigeria to record their foundations. What was our foundations? What was the purpose for independence? Why do we go for independence? What was we looking for when we clamored and agitated for independence? If we can remember what our first minister, prime minister said, then we will be able to trace back to our foundations. We can get the true picture of our foundations from the speech of our first prime ministers on the occasions of our independence on the first October 1960. Was it the day we get our independence? Am I hearing you? Good. Now, Tafawa Balewa said something on that first independence, and note what he said. He said, "At last, our great day has arrived." That was what he said. Now, if our great day have arrived, has any great man arrived? One thing is for the great day to arrive. Another thing is for great men to arrive. Our great day arrived, but there were no great men that arrived. That's the problem. So, but if you trace his speech, and look at his speech on that day, you will see the dream and the vision. And what was the dream? The dream was to bring together a nations or a nationalist. That is a true Nigeria that can unite together, that can stay together, that can be together, that can also have a true federation. That was the vision. Two, to bring a Nigeria that will not have partisan politics. And when you look at how Nigeria started, we never had what they called partisan politics, no personal pursuit, everybody paramount interest was to come together. Now that interest has been defeated. Anytime as a nation, or as a people, that you forget the very purpose why you are where you are, you're going to misbehave. Three, Nigeria was to be a spring forth or a wheel or a source of peace and joy for the nations. Don't forget, no spring water can flow on its own if the source of the water is cut off. And no tree also can grow if the root is removed. So therefore, if Nigeria failed to go back to its foundation, it cannot grow. The same thing to us as believers. If we fail to go back to the basis for church, we cannot grow. What was the basis for church? That church should be a ladder to take people to heaven. That's the basis. If church lost that basis and they're no longer thinking on how the church can be a ladder to take people to heaven, the church will become a club. So you cannot go anywhere if you lost your foundation. We can continue to enjoy the rest or the result of our neglect and abandon the cost. If you want to do that, but where will that take us to? My prayer is that God will call your memory to your foundation. So you should remember your foundation. Now you need to know what took me to this church. How did I get to this church? What is the foundation? What did I want to achieve? What was my primary reason for joining this church? What did God told me the first day I come? What am I fighting to get? What is my cause? Where am I supposed to go from where I am now? The day you forget what God told you, you will start remembering what man told you. And I'm telling you the truth. When once you forget what God told you, you start remembering what man told you. And when you start remembering what man told you, you start going into confusions. You became confused and missed the roadmap. Second alphabet on roadmap is what? O. Outlining our triumph and travail. We need to outline our triumph and travail. We must know where we are coming from in order to be to better participate and appreciate where we are going. As you look at Nigeria and see where Nigeria is coming from and where Nigeria is right now, you will better appreciate where we're going to. This is the only nations where every human beings are republic outside the nation. And yet, we are still going. It's only in Nigeria where you have to provide your borehole. You provide water for yourself, provide education for yourself, provide power for yourself. You are a republic on your own. Any day you stop being a republic, you will go nowhere. Why people die poor in Nigeria is because they want a nation. No. You don't need a nation in Nigeria. You need a republic. And every individual of this country is a republic on its own. You need to go and get somebody that will drill your borehole if you need water. You need to think of how you are going to go to school if you want. What? If you cannot do that, then be ready for failure. What people face is that they're waiting for government. Government should bring school. Government should bring the... In fact, they're even waiting for government to cook in their house for them to eat. You don't need that. Just know that you are a republic. Say it. Say it again. You're a republic. So you need to provide everything for yourself. But the beautiful part of it is that God has taken us so far. See the triumph we've recorded. The other day, they say one is called Boko Haram. We are surviving them. The other day, they say one is called banditry. We are surviving them. The other day, they say one is called militancy. We are surviving them. The other day, they say one is called kidnapping. We are surviving everything. And we are going. Is the only country in the world where you see people, they are very angry, but they cannot talk. And yet there is no war. We are going. We are the most wonderful people on the planet Earth. This is the only country, as a preacher, until you sweat, you've not preached. You've not preached. Go to other countries in the world. People come to church and take a cup of tea and just talk to themselves and they just go. And then you are asking them, can we pray more? They say, what are we praying for? There is no Satan. Nigeria, until you bind principalities, powers, you don't stop anything. You don't stop anything. In fact, if you don't give that man olive water, he's not satisfied. You must give him something that will show that the juju in his compound is dead before he will be happy. This is the only country where you see everybody, as he's leaving his house, is ready. If somebody fall down in that place they call Lagos, nobody will wait. Everybody will keep going. If that man need to die, let him die there. This is the only country everybody's in a hurry. Everybody is in a hurry. And yet, God is giving us triumph. This is the country where you see what they call atapiapia. Juju. The man will carry the juju and be enchanting. And yet, we are making progress. We are going. This is a country where you see you are doing election, they are shooting gun. And yet we are voting. And people, they win election. And where they go? You need to record our triumph. God has given us so much triumph in this country. So many things has happened that would have caused war in Nigeria. And yet there is no war. The same God that has given this country triumph will give us triumph. Amen. You're not giving me loudest amen. Our roadmap. What is the next alphabet? A. Accepting the assurance of hope and recovery. In Job chapter 14, Job 14, 7 to 9, we need to accept the assurance of hope and recovery, that there is hope. there will be recovery in this country. I'm not hearing you saying amen. If there is any night you need to say amen, if there is any day you need to pray, it's today, because we are talking about our nations. It's so paramount to me. I'm very, very happy because I don't have second Nigeria, and only one passport you can ever have. One tribe of this country say, oh boy, home now, home. Even though we go everywhere, home now, where? Home. So I say, Job 14 verse what? 7 to what? For there is what? Hope of a tree. If it be cut down. Did you see something? That tree is what? Eh? But yet, there is what? There is hope. See it. Some of you now, you say, I don't expire. Blah, blah, blah. I know they succeed again. My life don't end. Your life never end anything. There is hope. Say, there is hope. Say it again. If you cannot even say it from your mouth, how do you get it? Say it now. There is hope. Look at in verse 7. For there is hope of a tree, if it be cut down, that it will do what? Sprout again. And that the what? Tender branch thereof will not do what? Cease. Look at verse 8. Read it for me. After two, one, go. Though the root was old in the earth, and it does what? He will still grow. Look at verse 9. Yet through the scars of water, it will do what? Your life is coming back again. Nigeria is coming back again. In the name of Jesus. You see, it doesn't matter how bad would have been, there is hope. Take note of this. I need to give you this quote. It's a quote God gave to me this evening. I need to give it to you. And you need to write it down. Write it down. No one can go back and make a brand new start. No one can go back and make a brand new start. But anyone can start from now and make a brand new ending. Did you get that? Yes, sir. Did you get it? Yes, sir. All right, I take it again. No one can go back and make a brand new start. You cannot go back and expect to make a new brand start. You can't start a new brand life. You cannot say, I'm tired to continue and expect to make a new brand start. It's not possible. But anyone can start from now and make a brand new ending. So, the time you start is what matters in your ending or your beginning. It's not age. It's when you start. It's not when you are born. It's when you start. It's not where you stay. It's when you start. You can be in America. That doesn't mean that you have started. It's when you start. So therefore, it's not when Nigeria was born that matters. It's when Nigeria is ready to start that matters. Nigeria can decide to start today. And if Nigeria starts today, it may not be pleasing to is destroyed, the new cannot start. So therefore, if there are quotas, all of us need to contribute to make Nigeria a brand new start. So they can give us a brand new ending. Let's do it. And when we need to do it is now. And I pray that God will give us a wonderful nation in Jesus' name. Amen. Same thing applicable to your family. Applicable to your life. When you were born, that is not what matters to God. But when you start is what matters to God. In Isaiah 62, 6 to 7. Isaiah 62, 6 to 7. Ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silent. So we must perpetuate him on a daily basis of help and blessing. Keep not silent and give him no rest till he establish and till he makes Jerusalem a praise in the earth. God is going to make Nigeria a praise in this earth. Amen. I'm not hearing your amen. Amen. And God will make sunrise a praise in the earth in Jesus' name. Amen. Look at Jeremiah 29 verse 7. I read this as my last scripture. We're going to pray now. Jeremiah 29 verse 7. Seek the peace of the city. We need to seek the peace of Nigeria. Seek the peace of the city and pray unto the Lord for it. For in the peace thereof, ye shall do what? And then, for in the peace thereof, shall ye have peace. So if Nigeria does not have peace, you cannot have peace. Because it's in the peace of Nigeria, you can have. So we are going to pray three prayers tonight. We are going to pray for Nigeria. We are going to pray for your life. We are going to pray for this church. Stand up as we pray together. I want you to lift up your two hands up. Lift up your two hands up. And cry on behalf of Nigeria. Nigeria need rest. Nigeria need release. I want you to pray and say, Father, give rest to this country. Give release to this country. Renew this country. Let there be a reconciliation in this country. Let there be a reconciliation in this country. Let there be a restoration in this country. Let there be a reformation in this country. I can hear you praying for your country. This is your country. Pray for Nigeria. Pray for Nigeria. In Jesus' name we pray. I want us to leave our president to the Lord and all that works with him in his cabinet. That God will give them the direction. That God will open their eyes to a true roadmap to this country. And that God will use them to deliver this country in the name of Jesus. Let's open our mouth and pray for our president. And for all the ministers, several ministers, I expect you to pray better than the way you are praying. In Jesus' name we pray. We want to say, my Father, my Father, everything stolen from this country, oh Lord, restore them in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray right now. Let God restore our peace to this country. Let God restore joy in this country. Let God restore our educational system in this country. Let God restore what we have in our foundation in this country. Name we pray. If you can't pray for Nigeria tonight, it means you don't love this country. We want to declare tonight, every wrong man in Nigeria, anybody in Nigeria that doesn't want Nigeria to progress, any man in leadership, any devil, any power that is against this country, God should expel that person. That person should be expelled in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and command an expiration of evil people in this country. In Jesus' name we pray. Nebuchadnezzar got to a level when he made himself gods over the people and God make him an animal. Let God in heaven expire and retire any man, any woman that has kept Nigeria in one position. In the name of Jesus. We want to pray tonight and say, God, let your mercy prevail on this country. Open your mouth and pray for the mercy of God on this country. That his mercy will prevail on Nigeria. His mercy will prevail on this country. That God himself. We release and unleash his mercy on this country. In Jesus' name we pray. Give me another amen. We want to pray that nothing will shake the foundation of Nigeria. Nigeria will stand on its foundation and be renewed day by day. Open your mouth and pray for the foundation of this country. That God will make our foundation so firm, so strong, so powerful, so great. This foundation shall not be faulty. Open your mouth and pray. Jesus' name we pray. You're going to prophesy it upon your life and say, in this country I will prosper. In this country I will succeed. In this country I will go forward. Prophesy on your life right now. Open your mouth and prophesy upon your life that in Nigeria you will do well. In Nigeria we will grow. In Nigeria I will succeed in this country. I'll prosper in this country. I will have peace in this country. I will live in this country. I will have a breakthrough in this country. And I'm going to excel in this country. In Jesus' name we pray. A few minutes to go. I want you to lift up your right hand. I say, Father, show me my way. Show me the way to start now. Give me a better ending. Oh Lord, give me a roadmap to my life. Can you pray that prayer? It's very, very important. God, give me a roadmap to my life. I don't want to miss road. Just give me a roadmap to my life. Oh Lord, this is my humble prayer. That you give me a roadmap to my own life. Do it, Lord. Direction to my life. Direction to my life. In Jesus' name we pray. Finally, let's pray this prayer. Because sometimes we just pray this and then we take another prayer on the church. Then we round up. I want you to pray and say, just like Job said tonight, that the tree that is cut down, the hope still has hope. Say, God, renewed my hope again. Open your mouth and pray that prayer right now. Don't care to know where your hope has been lost. God, renew my hope again. But the Lord himself will renew your hope again. My hope shall not die. My hope for greatness will not die. Renew my hope, O Lord. My hope. In Jesus' name we pray. I want you to pray for sunrise. Sunrise will not miss this roadmap. Sunrise will not deviate from what he knows. Sunrise will not deviate from the revision. That God will uphold this church and keep this church.